Hello and welcome to the third home game of the Acadia Axewomen. Today against St. of X.
We have the starting lineups for the Acadia Axewomen: Alana Fairfax, Kathleen Bleakney, Catherine Drake, Jenna Blackburn, Jenna Hache, Chantal Landry, Sarah Reed, Andrea Murphy, Caroline Dobeck, Paige Bagnall, and Annette's Alicia Doyle. And starting for the St. of X Axewomen: Megan Ramson, Mallory McDonald, Jordan Brass, Olivia Zanette, Nicole McNeil, Alex Brech, Stacey Holland, Melanie Sindana, Maura Woodman, Victoria Penner, and in goal, Anna Thompson.
So I believe that's a throw-in for St. of X. And a goal kick for Acadia now. Kathleen Bleakney will be taking that.
So last Sunday, Acadia faced St. of X here at Acadia and ended with a 0-0 draw. So both teams will be out
for a goal. Okay. This is probably a game where
one goal could win it.
Exactly, yeah. And that was Chantal with an interception there, running down the line. And that's St. of X throw in. Anna Thompson will. Oh, that's close. Or even if we could, like, be out there, I guess.
That's a little better. Yeah, a little better.
Yeah. And that was a cross
defended.
In. Yeah, very well defended.
Better?
Yeah, thank you. And that's going to be a corner, I believe, for the Acadia Axewomen.
Kathleen Bleakney will step up to take that.
She usually takes the Acadia crosses. She has a very big kick. Acadia has scored a lot of their goals in the past off set plays.
Oh!
And there you go. There's a goal.
No way to see who scored that.
Yeah. It may just have knocked off someone. That's a good start. It wasn't a goal.
All right.
Guess it looked like it. You heard lots of people scream.
Cheering, and X is right back on the attack now.
I believe that is Zanetti down the line. And, yeah, there'll be a goal kick for Acadia. So we have the standings so far. UPEI is in first. They've played two games.
Two wins.
Yep. With four goals for and one goal against. Memorial is in second place with one tie and one win. Then there's Dow with one win and one loss. Cape Breton with one win. Mount Allison with a win and a loss, UMB with a tie, St. Vex with a tie, Acadia with a tie and a loss, and Moncton with a loss, and St. Mary's with a loss. Acadia's first game was against Cape Breton last Saturday.
Mm-hmm. Ended in a 2-0 result, but it was well fought.
Yep, both teams played very well. Acadia came out very strong, but just couldn't put one in the back of the net. There's a lot of rookies on the Acadia team. It's a fairly young team.
One recruit that's on the field right now is Jenna Blackburn from Brookside, Nova Scotia. She's actually played Canada games in both soccer and ringette, along with Alana Fairfax, who's also on the field right now. She played for Dunbrack this summer, who ended up winning the Premiership League, and they go to Nationals in Montreal, I believe, in October.
Another thing with the Acadia team is that a lot of the players have played together for a long time with Val United.
Yeah, exactly, over the summer.
So that's good. Good team chemistry. And that's going to be a goal kick. Anna Thompson will take that. Anna Thompson is in fifth year. She's just coming back from a partial MCL tear, I believe. So this is her second game in a long time. Training camp was the first time she came back and played for a couple months.
Jenna Hache on the Axewomen team also sustained a knee injury mid-season last year. And she actually re-injured it over the summer, and she was just cleared to play for training camp, so luckily for us.
That's Chantel Landry, just received the ball from Kathleen Blinkney. To Sarah, back to Chantel on the line.
It'll be an Axewomen throw.
Stacey Holland with an interception.
A good step by Jenna. Yeah. Jenna Hache.
And good tackle by Stacey Holland, Santa Vex.
Now up the field with it is Alex Brutch from Santa Vex.
A noted recruit for St. Vex this year is Maura Woodman. She's playing up front, I believe, or on the wing. She is number 18, originally from Halifax. She also played for Dunbrack this summer with Acadia's Jenna Blackburn. And Paige will chase it down in the corner to save it.
Nice cross by Chantel Landry.
And headed by Caroline Dobek. There are 13 returners on the Acadia team and 15 rookies, which is quite a lot. Acadia has looked very strong these last two games, though.
It's looking promising this year.
Yeah. Lots of speed up front, which is good.
Turn by Caroline Dobek. She tried to play a through ball, but intercepted by St. FX. And they'll come on the attack now.
Atlanta Fairfax will chase that back. And in the corner, St. FX has the ball. Nice if she could get some support there.
Attempt at a shot.
Yes. The coach for the St. Vex women is Trevor Reddick, and Amit Batra is the coach for Acadia. It's Amit's second year coaching the Axe women. And it is Trevor's 8th season coaching the St. Evex. And the ball will be played into the corner. Hoping they get it.
We think.
It's time to clear that.
Cleared by Andrea Murphy.
That's Chantel Landry.
Over to Jenna Hashay.
And to Catherine Drake.
CNFX had a lot of time on the ball there in the middle.
Yeah, Acadia should be closing that down. Top scorer for Acadia last year was Sarah Reed, who's on the field in the middle right now. She scored 2 goals. And Olivia Zanetti, who's playing up front for St. Evex, she had 4 goals for the Axewomen last year and was their top scorer. St. Evex finished 4th last year in the 2010 season. And went on to AUS champion or to the AUS championship, mm-hmm. which was held here at Acadia. St. Evex has only won. Or has won 2 AUS championships, one in 1986 and somewhat recently in 2009. Acadia has won a few more, none recently, but they have won 6 times, but not since 1966. And actually today is the reception for all alumni of the women's and men's soccer team, so they should all be here watching, and there's a reception held after.
Here we have a goal kick being taken by Kathleen Bleakney.
Last year, Acadia finished 9th in the standings. However, they did compete in the AUS
championships
because they hosted. Their first game, or they lost in the quarterfinals to Cape Breton 4-0. And Cape Breton went on to win it last year.
Acadia also had a first team All-Star last year, who is a graduated player, ZZ Layton. And for St. Effex,
they had 1 first-team All-Star, Megan Ramsden.
Who's a defender.
Yep, she is number 4, and she's on the field now. She is a third-year player from Ottawa. In preseason play, St. Evex had an exhibition game against Moncton, which they won 6-1. And we still take the kick. Drop kick. And Atlanta Fairfax will chase that down the line. And that will be a throw-in for the Acadia Axewomen. Last year, Anna Thompson, the goalie for St. Evex, only had 12 goals against, which is very good. She was also an All-Star, I believe, in her 2nd or 3rd year. Chantel will fight for that.
And cleared by St. Evex.
Andrea will take that down. Pass it over to Jenna Blackburn, who has lots of time.
Acadia's got really strong defending this year with two veteran players in Kathleen Bleakney and Andrea Murphy, the two center backs.
They do play very well together. Solid defense.
And Andrea Murphy was actually named the All-Star or Player of the Game last game against X,
which was on Sunday. It was brought out nicely by St. of X. Hopefully they can continue that. And
good pressure by the Axewomen.
They need to continue that.
That cleared by X.
I believe that was Stacey Holland. Ball will be played to Jenna Blackburn, Catherine Drake, I believe. Anyways, she sends that up the field, attempting to connect with Alana Fairfax, but couldn't make it. Ball is played out, and that will be a throw-in for St. of X. Big difference this year for Acadia, I don't know if you'd agree, is the depth, I think,
definitely,
on the team. You can tell, well, you can't see, but now there are lots of players on the bench who could easily
fill in any spot on the field, feel like. The recruitment class was very strong this year.
Mm-hmm. Another big addition to the team this year. She's not on the field right now, but Talissa Silzer, she's from Saskatoon. She captained Saskatchewan provincial team in 2010, last year at Nationals. And she's actually only 17 years old. It's not a very nice day out today. It's a good day to play soccer, I guess.
It's rather cold, yeah.
It is very windy, though. We've had a drastic change in weather from yesterday to today. And last year, Leisha Doyle had 8 goals against. She's played with Valley this summer, along with Chantal Landry, Kathleen Bleakney,
Sarah Reed,
a number of the girls.
Yeah.
And
she let just one goal in against, I think, Dunbrack, the defending national champions, which is
in club soccer.
Great for her.
Yes.
Hey girls, is the speed okay?
Mm-hmm. Acadia will go on to play Cape End. Is that a goal? No, I think it may have been called offside.
Yeah, I believe so.
Yeah. Acadia has had quite a few close calls though so far.
They're coming out strong this game, that's for sure.
Amit has changed up the lineup quite a bit from last game. Not necessarily the players, but
just the positions.
Where they are.
Yeah, exactly.
We have Caroline Dobek, who's playing up front. Last game she was playing in the middle. Paige Bagnell also up front, kind of filling in that hole between the center mids and the forward. She was on the wing last game. The defensive line usually stays the same, though. It's usually Andrea and Kathleen,
back there,
center backs. Jenna Blackburn on one side. And either Catherine Drake or someone else on the other side. So the first four games for Acadia will only be played against St. of X and Cape Breton.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of an interesting schedule. But so they will go to play St. of X, Cape Breton on Sunday. Mm-hmm. Throw in for St. of X. I believe that is Ramsden taking the throw. Mm-hmm. Sort of hard to tell, but.
And that's Jordan Brass fighting for it, and now double teamed
by Sarah Reed and Kathleen Bleakney. Good challenge by Chantal Landry. She'll take it down the line and get a cross in, but there's no one there to finish. Caroline Dobek trying to get a shot off, but St. Evex is defending very well today.
They are.
Lana Fairfax down the corner. She'll try to get a cross off. She's sending it back to Jenna Blackburn. Jenna Ashe will pass to Sarah Reed, who got it played into the box, and I believe that was called offside. Acadia has been caught a couple times.
Yeah, early on, but yeah. They have got a few scoring opportunities as well, so. Yeah.
They're pressing. I believe the last couple minutes have really just been in the scene of X. Mm-hmm. I noticed that with the last couple games, Acadia was able to press very high. Press hard at the beginning of the game, but slowly that started to die. So they can keep up the intensity. That would be good.
I believe that was Jenna Blackburn to Alana Fairfax coming down the wing. An attempt at a tackle there by X. And I believe the ball was called out, so it's an Acadia throw-in. Back to Fairfax. Attempted a through ball there by Jordan Brass.
Keisha Doyle will take that with her feet and pass back to Andrea Murphy. Also like to mention the men's game on Sunday, which was against St. Evex.
That was a very close good game.
Yeah.
Acadia came out strong early.
Yeah, they scored 3 goals in 20 minutes, I believe it was. 2 of them by John O'Hammond and another one by Liam Dutton. Kind of a surprise considering St. Evex went undefeated
in
last year.
Season play, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Well fought there by Andrea Murphy and Jordan Brass.
Well, Olivia Zanetti, or no, sorry, that is Melanie Sonata. Melanie was also one of the top scorers last year for St. Evex with 2 goals.
Kathleen Bleakney will take the kick and easily hit it away by X. Good pressure by Caroline Dobek. I believe that is a goal kick for Anna Thompson.
Left in the first half. And
again, Jordan Brass in the middle.
We play Santa Rex playing up the field, and that will be a throw in for Acadia. Taken by Catherine Drake, I believe. Catherine Drake is a first year from Prince Edward Island.
Picked up by Jenna Hashe and over to the wing for Jenna Blackburn.
Jenna had some time on that ball. Played a nice ball across, but wasn't able to link up with someone up front. Long ball played.
And that'll be an X throw. Looks like it's getting a little sunnier out there.
Yeah. Clouds look awfully dark, though. Might get some rain here. I'd say it's been a fairly evenly played game so far.
Yeah, so far.
Acadia has had a few more dangerous opportunities, but I think St. Vex has only had about one shot on net. Maybe not even. And Kathleen Bleakme will take that goal kick. This is actually really good weather to play soccer
it
for
is.
The players.
It's not too hot.
Might be cold to watch, but
yeah.
Keeps the players cool.
And one by Santa Fex.
No, you're taken down by Sarah Reed. Picked up the field.
Chased down by both Paige Bagnell and Chantal Landry.
And Santa Fex wasn't able to keep that in. That'll be a throw-in for Acadia. Taken by Catherine Drake. St. Vex will play a long ball out.
And one in the middle.
Can she get there? Andrea Murphy was able to get in between the player or the ball and the player and win that. Played out to Jenna Blackburn.
Oh, well tackled by St. Vex. There must have been a substitution for Acadia. We missed that. It looks like Talissa Silzer is on the field.
Talissa, yes. Talissa's from Saskatoon, along also with Andrea Murphy. Talissa played, I believe it was right back last game against Santa Fe. Looks like she's on the wing today.
I think she's a pretty versatile player. It seems that she's dangerous wherever they
I know in the exhibition games, she even played up front and played very well. She was able to get a couple crosses in that Atlanta finished. Chantal Landry will chase that back. And won by Sarah Reed.
I believe Talissa took off Alana Fairfax, as far as I can tell.
Alana might be having some back problems.
Yeah.
She did hurt her back last... she's had ongoing back pain, back injury. Well intercepted by St. Vex there to clear that out.
And she connects with a player up front.
I believe that's Sonata.
Dangerous. Could be dangerous.
Yeah, that was a nice cutback.
And a good save by Alicia Doyle.
That was a very nice cutback to be able to get that shot
it
off.
It was by Jordan Brass. Probably the best opportunity yet for X this game.
Yeah, I'd say so. But Alicia Doyle was there.
That'll be an Acadia throw-in. Taken by Jenna Blackburn.
Katie also played some exhibition games in their preseason. They had a little mini tournament with Dallas Mew, where they played our games, and they won against Mew 1-0. And Alana Fairfax scored that goal, and they tied Dallas 0-0. Then they headed to Mount A and won 2-0. The goal by Alana Fairfax and Becca Stuns. Becca's on the bench right now. But I'm sure she'll be out there soon. Becca is also a very versatile player. She plays pretty much anywhere.
Yeah. Well tackled by X again. Their defense is pretty
solid. Playing very well today,
yeah.
Haven't been able to do too much up front, though.
No.
But they do have players who can score. That's for sure.
Good battle there, but won by Sedana, I believe.
Yes.
Yep.
Melanie Sonata, yeah. well fought by Caroline Dobeck.
And she wins it. And a nice through ball.
Will she be able to finish it?
And saved by Anna Thompson. We would like to see Bagnell get a little more on that shot, but it was a really nice through ball by Dobeck.
Yeah. Should try to hit the far post, I'd say, there. Mm-hmm. But it's hard when you're up there.
And a good opportunity, though, for the Axewomen.
That was a nice ball played by Caroline.
And well stolen by Chantelle Landry. And Caroline Dobeck again with pressure up front. But I believe they called that a foul on her. So X will have a free kick.
And on
just outside the 18.
On Sunday, St. of X will have their first home game against Memorial. Sun's really coming out. They'll be hired on Leisha Doyle and Anna Thompson.
It will.
Goalkeeper's nightmare. That in the rain on turf. And there'll be another throw in for Acadia, taken by Catherine Drake. Good throw. One by St. of X.
And cleared by Melanie Sonata.
Olivia Zanetti will try to get that, but Kathleen Bleakney was able to clear that out.
Another throw by Sonata.
Put back to Sonata. Again, a clearance by Kathleen Bleakney. Caroline is able to take that down. Caroline's a very strong player.
She is. For a rookie, she is playing very well.
She is playing very well. She can definitely hold her own out there. Mm. She doesn't look young or anything,
no.
You know, against older players. She is from South Shore, I believe.
Yeah, right? She played for South Shore United, I believe.
Andrea Murphy will settle that. Get some pressure from St. of X, who wins it.
Oh, and a nice through ball, but well saved by Leisha
Doyle.
Leisha
was able to save it and cleared by Andrew Murphy. That was probably their best opportunity so far.
I would say so.
That was very dangerous.
Just a small slip up by Acadia defense, but...
Just played it right through the center backs.
Another cross by St. of X.
It's a good cross, but... Leisha Doyle wasn't able to hold on to that, but it is cleared. And number 13, Shannon Venedam, I believe. Take that throw. Looks like Becca Stuns is waiting at half to get into the game. See who she takes off. My guess is she'll be going up front.
And Becca actually took off Jenna Hashay in the middle.
Possibly some knee
issues, yeah.
Yeah. Has been bugging her a bit. I think both teams really want to win this. I mean,
they do. One goal could win this game, I believe.
Yeah, definitely. Cleared by Jenna Blackburn. One by St. of X, and they will take it down the line. This could be dangerous.
Good steal by Sarah Reed, but back to X again. She's got a lot of time on the ball there, but...
Yeah.
Luckily, a missed pass.
Andrea will shield that out. Two other big recruits. We mentioned Maura Woodman for St. of X. but also Sonia Boucher from Aurora, Ontario, who usually plays in the middle or defense, and Gabby Berg, who is from Calgary and is a defender. Also, both captains, or the captains for Acadia and St. Vex, one of the captains, Jenna Hache, she's from Calgary, and actually she went to high school with Anna Thompson, the goalie and captain for St. Vex.
Here you have a nice through ball by St. Vex, cleared well by Bleakney. Chased down there by Shannon Van Dam.
But couldn't keep it in. Chantel Landry will take the throw.
Van Dam again.
Played around the back and cleared. The other team really won that, but St. Vex ended up with the ball. Lots of time on the ball.
Yeah, Kitty seems to be
not
backing
much pressure,
off a little bit.
Yeah. St. Vex definitely has some players that can shoot well, so mm-hmm. I wouldn't want to give them much space.
Exactly. And Kathleen Bleakney will send it over to Jenna Blackburn on the wing. And she sends it down the field. Took up with Talissa Silzer. Back to Blackburn, but... Oh, and well tackled by Blackburn to win that back twice. She has lots of pressure on her, double-teamed, and won by Lauren Brass. Sorry, Jordan Brass.
Yeah, Jenna's a small player, but she is very strong.
Yeah, she has very technical tackles.
There's 8 minutes left in this half. And Talissa Silzer will win that in the middle and play it up to Paige, I believe. But that was cleared out by St. Vex. Nice ball on the ground. And that was attempted a shot. That went wide. Kathleen Bleakney will take a goal kick again. One by St. Vex in the air and brought down nicely. Couldn't quite get the pass off though. With Silder pressuring that.
And one by Andrea Murphy in the air.
The ball needs to be settled down here, I think. And it was a nice slide tackle by Catherine Drake. We'll go out for a corner though. St. Vex is very good on set plays.
They are.
Seen them score quite a few goals that way. Not quite sure who that is taking it. It's a nice ball in, but
punched away by Doyle. Jordan Brass was right on her there. An unlucky call for Caroline Dolbeck.
You can hear Emma Batra was not too happy about that. That's Jordan Brass taking that, or?
I believe it might be Zanetti. Or possibly not. It's hard to see the numbers from here.
Yeah. And Bucket Stunts will play that up to
Caroline Dobeck, I believe.
Yeah. And then a long ball played through.
And they're still chasing it.
Played back to. Oh, that was close.
Unlucky.
That was offside. Ball's been played back to Anna Thompson.
picked up by X.
They have lots of time.
Still has the ball.
Jenna will start to pressure there. Chase her down.
Well tackled.
Yeah, that's very good. This could be dangerous if she gets a cross off. And Katie will win that, and it was cleared out by Jenna, I believe. Caroline is very good at using her body.
She is.
Yeah.
A nice through ball down to Sonata, but picked up by Chantal Landry.
And that one off Olivia Zanetti. That'll be Acadia their win. Taken by Catherine Drake.
Good throw, but picked up.
Ooh.
Oh. Well in by Becca Stuns.
She kind of just threw her whole body in there.
Picked up again by X.
But
Paige
Bagnell was able to win that. It's very good.
It's a little too far, and Anna Thompson will pick that up.
Alyssa Sills are there trying to make it, but the X goalie was able to pick that up with no problem. I believe that's Stacey Holland for X coming down the wing with the ball. And picked up by Zanetti. She would get a shot off.
Quick shot, just off.
It was a nice turn, though.
Mm-hmm.
And 3 minutes left. So this kind of looks like the game on Sunday, I'd say.
It does. Very evenly played.
Very even, yep. No goals.
To Silzer.
That's Maura Woodman for X pressuring her. And
pressure by Paige Bagnell, but picked up by Anna Thompson. A nice pass to the defender. X seems to be very good at playing the ball on the ground to feed.
Yeah, they are. Yeah. Oh. Bringing the ball down.
Mm-hmm.
It's really the easiest way to play. Anna Thompson there. She'll roll the ball out to, I believe that's Nicole McNeil. Nicole's from the New Glasgow area. It's her third year. She'll play that back to Anna Thompson. With
trying
lots
to find
of time.
A way out here.
Yeah. Acadia's
pressuring well.
Yeah, they have picked up the pressure quite a bit. They've won a lot of balls
mm-hmm.
in the last couple minutes. But X on the counterattack. Put a ball on the ground nicely. Only that made it just past Andrea. Probably would have been a goal or a shot.
Looks like we have a substitution for X.
I believe that is
number. Is that Zanetti?
I don't think so, but number 10, Sarah Cannell, is coming into the game. She is second year, and she's from Thunder Bay, Ontario. This is Stacey Holland taking the throw-in. She takes all their throw-ins in the attacking third.
Yeah, she has a very big throw.
Yeah. It's almost a kick.
Yeah.
As long as a kick. Which is unusual for women's soccer.
It is. You don't see that often.
Yeah, exactly.
So they use her wisely.
She'll play it short there.
Jordan Brass.
The cross. Chantal Landry was able to play that out. But Sainovec putting it back in. Dangerous bouncing ball.
X seems to be pressing here in the final minutes.
Yep. Most goals do come right before.
A nice cross by, I think, Maura Woodman.
The majority of the goals do come right before half.
And the end of the game, that's right.
Yeah. So those few minutes, you just need to hang in there.
Yeah.
So if they can go into the second half 0-0, I mean, it's a completely new game.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, by X. Rachel Dragon playing it over, but couldn't connect with X player. And
that'll be
halftime.
So we will be back in after the 15-minute break.
And welcome back to the second half of Acadia's third home game against St. Evex. If you're just tuning in, the score is 0-0. And it's been a pretty even game, wouldn't you say?
I would.
And both Acadia and St. Evex have had some good opportunities.
Alana Fairfax is back on the field.
Yeah, she went off in the first half, I believe, because we're back, but maybe not. And that is Paige Bagnell. Katie will start with the ball. Looks like the girls are finding it a bit cold out there. And Jenna Blackburn will play back to Leisha. We'll kick it out. Whoa, there we go. Lana Fairfax will try to play that up, but it's unable to. And Rachel Dragon wins that. We still are coming out. Easily grabs that.
And picked up by St. Effex. Nice through ball by Paige Bagnell.
Talissa Silzer picked that up at the top of the 18-yard box, but wasn't able to do much with that.
I believe that must have been an offside call.
Yeah.
A free kick for
Did it look like she came in from behind? Not too many big saves were had to be made in the first half by Alicia Doyle or Anna Thompson. A couple close calls, but nothing...
Nothing major, no.
Nothing major. Not any really good opportunities.
No.
Well, good opportunities, but maybe not... Good finishes. Say. Nicole McNeil.
Good pressure by Silzer.
Yeah, tried to clear that out, but couldn't. Lana Fairfax will try to win that, but that's played out by St. Evex. St. Evex will carry that through the middle. Played down nicely by St. Evex. They are very good at controlling the ball on the ground. Maybe something Katie needs to work on a little bit.
And a nice cross there from X, but picked up by Alicia Doyle.
That's close. Jordan Brass tried to finish that, but couldn't quite. Drop kick from Alicia Doyle. And that was won by St. Evex.
Picked up by Sarah Reed.
Settled by Jenna Blackburn, but good pressure from St. Evex.
They seem to be picking up the pace a little
this
half.
They are, yeah. They kind of look like what Acadia looked like the last couple minutes of the first half, winning those tackles.
We'll take a free kick from Kathleen Bleakney. Sorry, goal kick. Good battle there by Sarah Reed in the middle.
Jenna Blackburn. Nice little pass up to Sarah Reed. Another nice pass. When Acadia does start passing on the ground, they are a very good
team.
They
do connect well. That's
yeah.
Right.
Something they should do more. Not that it's an easy thing to do. But when they do it, they are successful. Crossing by Catherine Drake, I believe. And that will be a St. Evex throw in. Played through the back. St. Evex trying to get that out. They can through the middle.
And a nice touch from Andrea Murphy to clear it out to the wing to Talissa Silzer.
Playing up to Alana Fairfax, but St. Evex will win that.
A nice tackle by Paige Bagnell.
Yeah. talking to Silzer, to Jenna Blackburn, who's trying to play that ball through on the ground. Jenna Hache, that's right. But couldn't quite get it past her. Jenna Hache again, trying to get a cross off, and she will. But Anna Thompson will easily pick that up. Cole McNeil over to
Sonata.
Yeah. Dragon,
I believe. The field. I think it's Sonata. Number 11. It is Dragon.
Dragon won't play that long, but no one from St. Nevex to pick that up. So that'll be a goal kick for Acadia, taken by Kathleen Bleakney. Minutes left. Still lots of time. The score is still 0-0.
One in the air by X, by, I believe, Jordan Brass.
It's Jordan Brass there with the ball.
Yep. And that'll be a free kick for Acadia. Collision there with Sarah Reed. To the foul. And kicked up by Kathleen Bleakney. Lana Fairfax tried to settle it, but won by X. Battling back now. And Acadia wins the ball back.
Taken down by Nicole McNeil, who will play it over to Rachel Dragon on the ground. And up to number 2, Stephanie Cameron. That'll be played out by Acadia. So that'll be a throw-in for St. of X. Usually he Stacey Holland takes those throw-ins, but I don't think she did that time. Nice ball played through on the ground.
By Megan Ramston, I believe.
Yeah, and across, but couldn't keep it in. That's a goal kick again. Kathleen Bleakney will take that. It's pretty windy out there. As you can see on the top of the screen, those flags moving. So that might be compromising.
And there is Paige Bagnell on the wing, but won by X. Sarah Reed sends it through to Bagnell on the wing.
But St. of X gets that and clears that out. Gets control by Brass on the wing. Able to keep it, even with two Acadia defenders on her. And Jenna Hache with the ball, taking it down and playing it up. Couldn't quite get it over or link up with the player. There haven't been much subs for either team.
No.
I wouldn't say. There definitely could be on both sides. There are players who...
Dangerous here in front.
Who could be on, but...
Both teams are playing the ball in the air a lot more this half.
I would say,
last half, St. FX was playing through balls into feet.
A lot more on the ground.
Yeah.
Looked a lot nicer.
Another goal kick by Kathleen Bleakney.
Had a few of those already.
A little shorter that time.
Probably not what she was wanting.
Bit of a miss hit there.
That'll be a throw in by Rachel Dragon. Up to number 2, Stephanie Cameron, playing it back to Stacy. No, not Stacy Holland, I don't think.
Sarah Cannell, I think.
Okay. Jordan Brass wins that, puts it back to Cannell, and nice. St. Evex is really linking up right here. You get a shot off, Alicia Doyle picks that up.
St. Evex is really pressing early this half.
Yeah.
I think Katie needs to step it up a little bit.
I think the same thing can be said for both teams. They look pretty even.
Yeah.
All game, and even last game on Sunday when they played them. It's a lot alike, both teams.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely a big change from last year. There's a lot more depth, a lot of new players on the Acadia team, which have added a lot, I think, in a good way. To be a little more competitive.
Yeah, I agree.
Whereas last year, I believe, they ended the season with a loss. I think it was 2-0. Against St. Evex. Zanetti, the ball. She's able to keep it, even with pressure by two Acadia defenders. Over to number 11, Rachel Dragon. Back to Zanetti. And she will get a shot off. But
easily picked up by Doyle. We'll clear it now.
It's a long shot.
And off of X, and Silzer will play it in. Trying to get it to Fairfax,
but... quite. Jenna Hashday picks up in the middle. Good slide tackle by number 10, Sarah Cannell. Oh.
Misplayed there and picked up by Reed.
But Reed kicks it out. There'll be a throw-in for St. of X.
I believe Chantal Landry is back on the field.
Yeah.
Well...
she played well the first half. St. of X will play it across the back, playing it safe. Trying to pass their way out, which is good. Seems
good
to be
pressure
working.
From Silzer.
Yeah. That was a nice ball, but will she get it? She thought she had it. That was close. That would have been very nice.
Blackburn will take the throw for Acadia. Trying to find someone here. And one by X.
Sarah Cannell down the line. By Cannell yet. She'll try to get a cross off, but it goes right to Leisha Doyle. Fifty-fifty ball between Paige Bagnell and number 4, Megan Ramston. St. of X came out with winning that one.
Cleared by Bleakney. Almost all the way down the field. Yeah. And X will pick it up. A little pressure from Bagnall. But X will clear that easily through the middle.
Through Sarah Cannell. Seen this a number of times where X tries to clear... or get it out of there and by playing through the middle, then back out wide, and then up. It seems to be working.
It does.
Rather than just kicking it and hoping for the best.
Yeah, those 50-50 balls.
Yeah. Pressure by Chantal Landry on the wing. And Kathleen Bleakney will clear that out. Chantal Landry with the ball.
Trying to connect with Bagnall, but...
Megan Ramson was able to pick that up and pass wide. Back to through the middle.
Cannell. Back to the wing.
And back to Ramson.
And again, passing it through the back.
She has lots of time.
Ex-defenders seem to play with a lot of poise there. They're confident in working around the back and looking for a way through.
Twissa Silzer there up front did show she's there. She is quite fast.
Mm-hmm. Good pressure.
Yeah. This will be a throw-in for Acadia. Looks like we're having a substitution here.
Jenna Hashay coming off.
We'll see who's going on. And Kiva McParland will go on. She's a first year from Halifax, played for Halifax City with Kelly Hennessy, another player on Acadia. They've played together for a long time. She's a good player. She always seems to be playing in the middle.
Mm-hmm. That'll be an X throw in.
We'll play it back.
Around through the back line again.
Some pressure by Bagnall.
And Silzer as well.
Good pressure by Jenna Blackburn, but number 2, Stephanie Cameron's able to keep it in, bring it down to the corner, and she's double teamed by Alana and Jenna.
And well defended. That'll be an Acadia throw.
It's very good.
But almost picked up by X, actually. Pretty easily.
Looks like Caroline Doback is going to be coming back in, number 4, at the bottom of the screen.
X on the attack now.
Did we see who came in for Jenna?
Kiva.
Kiva, right.
And crossed by Dragon. But cleared away by Fairfax.
Good slide tackle. Dragon playing it over to Canal, but Acadia wins it. Paige showing some speed. Kiva might almost have that.
Good pressure there from Chantal Landry, but X will pass it to the wing. Some nice footwork there and a nice cross, but just a little high.
Be another goal kick for Acadia. I'd say this half, mostly X has been...
Yeah.
I mean, we've seen...
The past few minutes, it's been a lot in Acadia's end.
We've seen a lot of goal kicks from Kathleen Whitney in the last 10 minutes. So they have had a lot of attempts on net. But no finishes. Caroline Dobek will take the throw. Up to Alana Fairfax, but she can't get it. Canal there. Caroline winning the ball. Yeah, that was good.
Catherine Drake on the wing.
Trying to play it to Kiva, but Sainovex was able to get that. Back to Canal in the middle.
Dragon will chase that down. Played out by Blackburn to Fairfax. Back to Blackburn, who will clear that out. Nice defense there from Acadia. And high and wide from X. And yet another goal kick from Kathleen Bleakney. Picked up by X in the middle. Paige Bagnall sends it out to the wing, trying to hook up with Talissa Silzer. And Bleakney will clear it again. X seems to be winning a lot of those 50-50 balls in the air this game. It'll be an Acadia throw, taken by Blackburn. To Sarah Reed, who sends the ball down the line to the corner. Just a little far. Again, looking for that way through, but good pressure from Bagnall. And picked up by Reed in the middle.
Out to Bagnall again. Talissa was there. If she can get it to her. Good try. That was close. It was a good ball played by Dobek. Just a little out of
reach.
Just a little out of reach. Anna Thompson will take that drop kick. And settled well by Zanetti. Over to Canal.
Good pressure there from Silzer. Out to Dragon. We'll take on Alana Fairfax down the line. A nice cross, but...
Brass wasn't able to do much with that. A little flick, but...
Silzer will take it through the middle.
Andrea Murphy facing her own net. That is a goal by St. of X.
Unlucky for Alicia Doyle, I think.
Yeah.
She didn't think that shot was going to be hit.
No.
And who was that scored by?
I think that might have been Zanetti.
She fell a little bit just before taking the kick, but it trickled in there.
Like we said earlier, I mean, with this evenly matched game, one goal could definitely win it for the team. Still lots of time left, though, for Acadia to get a goal.
Oh, yeah. I think we'll see them start to pick up the pace a little now with some urgency. Fairfax down the line. Trying to keep it in, but just not a little far. We haven't seen much play from Acadia down in this end.
Not this half,
particularly
no.
On this left side over here. But Fairfax can get some good crosses when she hits them, so...
She can. She can also finish well.
That's right.
Like we said, during the exhibition games, she scored 2 goals. And both, I believe, were assisted by Talissa. Mm-hmm. So they can connect.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, Jenna Blackburn with the ball. Back to Andrea Murphy. Back to Jenna again. Turned well. And she's able to play that over to Sarah Reed. But X ends up with the ball.
Cannell through the middle.
Paige Bagnall.
Good step by Bagnall, yeah.
Probably would have been better to play it on the ground to Talissa there, I'd say, but that'll be an X throw in.
Pressure from Dobek.
I like Dobek playing up front.
I do.
She
it's
adds
good
a lot of pressure.
For Katie,
yeah,
that's right.
To have someone strong, like physically up there. She's a very physical player, which is good.
Played out off Fairfax there, and Dragon will take the throw in down the line. That's Stephanie Cameron in the quarter battling with Jenna Blackburn.
Zanetti.
And a bit of a miss hit there from X. Alicia Doyle will gather it for a goal, a goal kick.
Kathleen Bleakney will take that again. We have seen a lot of goal kicks by Kathleen Bleakney this half, which kind of shows that all the play has been down here.
A lot of it has been, that's right.
A lot of pressure from X.
A very nice kick from Bleakney, but picked up by X.
Caroline Dobek, or Talissa, sorry. Lana can't quite get there. That's played out by St. Evex. Sarah Reed now with the ball for Acadia. Playing it out wide to trying to connect with Atlanta, but couldn't quite. And there's Brass with the ball. Playing it to the middle.
Cameron coming down the middle. No one out wide for her there, so she attempts a shot, but...
was stopped by Catherine Drake, I believe.
Acadia needs to play a little more to feed, I think.
The
ex-defenseman seem to be picking it up pretty easily back there.
It's something X is doing pretty well this game, is playing on the ground, playing to feet, passing a lot, and not forcing the ball.
That's right.
You know, playing it back if you need to, playing to the open players. I think that also comes with experience, though.
And yeah.
X is a much more, not much more, but they are an experienced team.
A lot more veterans, I think, on
the
field at the moment.
Yeah. But that will come with time for Acadia.
Yeah, exactly.
Maybe not this season, but it will be good in the future.
Good battle there between Kiva and...
Dragon with the throw. Play that back, and Nicole McNeil sends that forward. And played out by Sarah Reed. Kiva, the ball, and that is a foul. Against St. Evex. Katie will have a free kick here. Kathleen Bleakney will most likely take this.
Yep, that's right.
The amount of kicks she takes in a game, it's quite a few.
It's key for Acadia to win this 50-50 ball up in Santa Fe's end. Put some pressure on them. But headed away by X.
Hopefully they can keep it down here.
Sarah Reed tries to turn, but stripped of the ball there.
It was through ball, but just a little too much pace on it. Drop kick by Alicia Doyle.
Sills are trying to bring it down, but picked up by X.
And that'll be a throw-in for Acadia.
I believe that was Bagnall who took the first touch.
A little far away. Touch went a little far, or the ball went a little far from her. First touch is key.
Yeah, especially at this level.
So even if you win the ball, but you have a bad first touch, then...
That's right.
You know, you're going to lose it. Saint of X has possession.
Playing around the back again.
They're very good at doing that. Just keeping possession, passing around until they have an opportunity to do something with it. They've had a lot of the possession this half.
Picked up by Bleakney here, and she'll let that go out for a goal kick.
Another goal kick.
Dobek sends it up to Fairfax.
So this is what we're kind of talking about. If Dobek was able to bring that ball down and control it, that probably would have been better. Make it pass on the ground and just keep possession. Just knock it around, sort of like X is doing. Cole McNeil with the throw. Again, won by St. of X. And Cameron.
Good pressure there from Blackburn. Yeah.
Zanetti with the ball. Pressure by Paige Bagnell on Cadeau, or Cannell, is it? Yeah.
And just a little far, so Acadia will take that throw in. Really helps to have those ball girls there out on the on the track.
It definitely makes
the
a big
game
difference.
A little faster.
It does. It's also good for the players.
That's right.
So that they're not wasting energy
exactly.
running after the balls. And yeah, it makes the play go faster.
Mm-hmm. Cannell plays it back to her defense.
Cole McNeil pass that back.
A little more pressure there from Dobek.
Yeah.
Good to see.
That could have been dangerous had Paige been up a little farther.
Nice through ball there to Brass. Sends it down the line.
Can't
just a little
quite
far.
Make it, yeah.
Catherine Drake will take that throw in for Acadia. Reed battling there in the middle. Well held by Dobek to Bagnall. Good speed there, but well slide tackled by X. I believe it's an Acadia throw-in now, taken by Drake.
Alyssa tried to keep that, but she couldn't. Saint of X playing it out. Number two, Cameron, I believe?
Yep.
Jenna will jockey that. Couldn't win it.
Nice footwork there from Cameron.
Yeah, that was very nice.
I mean, Saint Effects throw.
By Nicole
taken
McNeil.
By, yep.
Over to Olivia Zanetti. As we mentioned before, Olivia was the top goal scorer for Saint Effects last year with 4 goals, followed by Sonata with 2. Looks like we're going to have a substitution here. Number 21, Laura Keys for Acadia coming in. Laura played, I believe, 80 minutes last game.
Yeah, she played a lot against X last game.
She's a very hard worker. She's
a
hustler.
Yeah, lots of speed up front, that's for sure.
Yeah, exactly. Good pressure on the ball, and that's probably what Acadia needs right now.
Alicia Doyle with the drop kick. Clump of players there in the middle, and Saint Effects comes out with it.
Lana Fairfax there. When's the throw-in? And we'll have that substitution. Laura Keys coming in. Can't see right now. You can see Liz Cook at the bottom of your screen. She is the
goalie coach for Acadia.
Yeah. She also played with Jenna Blackburn this summer for Dunbrack Club Soccer. And they won, so they'll be going to Nationals.
I believe Bagnall came off, so Laura Keys will be going up front there for Acadia.
That'll be a good change. Zanetti with the ball, nice turn.
Nice turn.
She'll get a shot off, but easily picked up by Alicia Doyle.
You see 15 minutes left in this half.
Not much time left, but anything can happen.
There's Cameron again coming down the wing.
Sarah Reed with the ball. She'll keep possession easily. Over to Atlanta Fairfax. Back to the through the middle to Andrea Murphy. And out wide to Drake.
It's nice to see Acadia playing it through the back a little more.
It's getting a little dark now. Sun's gone down. Those lights will be turned on soon.
Silzer sends it down the line to Keys. Trying to hold on to it, but cleared by X defense.
Cleared by Kathleen Bleakney. One by St. of X in the middle, though. They'll take that up.
Lena Not Fairfax.
Much pressure. And that's called offside. Stephanie Cameron there. So that'll be a kick for Acadia, taken by Kathleen Bleakney.
Good battle there, it looked like, but X came up with a throw and Dragon mishits that.
Into the bench.
And Reed will take the throw in for Acadia. Keys tackled well.
Jenna Blackburn took that down quickly.
Very well.
And over to Andrea Murphy. Andrea Murphy's playing up a little more.
She is. She looks like
I
she's in a central
yeah.
position.
Trying
to get some
unusual.
Pressure up front. Yeah.
See the men warming up in the end zone. Mm-hmm. They play next. So if Andrew Murphy's in the middle, it'll be interesting to see who has dropped back
yeah.
in center back. Because that is Andrew's role for 90 minutes of
yeah.
every game is center
Key
back.
Position.
Yeah. So let's see. Looks like Kathleen Bleakney is still back there. And I think Jenna Blackburn went back there.
There's Blackburn there.
Yeah. Maybe they've only decided to go with three in the back.
I think
so,
and
Andrea's
pushing up.
Yeah, so trying to play a little more offensive mm-hmm. in the last 12 minutes or so. Put some more pressure on X and hopefully get a goal and tie it up.
Good defense there
yeah.
by Blackburn.
That'll be Acadia throw-in.
Or extra run.
Yeah.
Dragon will take that.
Settled
for
by Zanetti.
Oh, Zanetti. And headed back in by X. Next, we'll work it around the back again. Some pressure here from X.
It's Brass out wide with the ball. Hopefully, she can get some support there. Pass back, and that will be an X throw-in.
It's about 10 minutes left now, I think. Katie is going to really have to put some pressure on.
It's able to be saved there. That looks like Allison Sutherland back there.
It does, but she
I don't think so,
no.
though. So, that'll be a throw-in now. It was a good save rather than a corner kick. Those can be very dangerous. Or it is a corner kick. So she wasn't able to save it.
Nice ball in, but cleared out by Acadia defense.
Twist the Soldier will run that down, pressure the X player out wide.
Good
and
pressure
she wins
there.
That. It's very good. She was taken down. That will be a foul against St. of X. So we'll have another free kick taken by Kathleen Blakeney. Hopefully we can get this, Acadia can get up this up the field and...
Mm-hmm, keep it up there.
Yeah. The first half seemed to be pretty even, but I think X is coming out on top this half.
Yeah, they've started to pick it up,
yeah.
There's Reed in the middle with the ball, over to Silzer.
Nice pass to Kiva. She'll keep possession, play it back. To Drake. Drake plays it out wide to Talissa, who can't quite make it up the line, so that'll be a throw-in for St. of X.
St. of X is really putting a lot of pressure on each position on the field, it seems like.
Yeah. Anna Thompson, their goalie, hasn't had to do much this half.
No.
I think just one or two goal kicks. Throw for St. of X. Down to the corner with Brass. Nice ball.
And quickly through.
That's a cross. Misha Doyle picks that up. Not much time left. St. of X picks that up. Number 11, Rachel Dragon.
And
but
Alana
won by
Fairfax.
Alana Fairfax. Sarah Reed with the ball. Plays it out wide to Jenna Blackburn, who made a nice run up the line. And Talissa...
Looking for Dobek,
yeah,
but...
Or Dobek, yeah. Can't quite...
They have the same cleats.
Yeah, they do. This will be a throw-in for St. of X. Looking to take their time. Try to waste it, probably.
Oh, but an Acadia throw. Lucky break there.
Lana Fairfax will take that, number 22.
They're trying to speed things up a little bit. That didn't play quickly.
Andrea Murphy. Over to Caroline Dobek, who has the ball.
Well
nice.
Kept.
Yeah, very well. And a cross
nice
in.
Nice cross from Alana.
And can't quite finish it. Scramble in front of the in front of the 6-yard box there. That was very dangerous. Good cross by Alana Fairfax.
And good play by Dobek.
But St. of X was able to clear that. Andrea Murphy with the ball in the middle. And Talissa Silzer will run that down the corner. Should be able to keep it. Oh. I would say that looked like a foul.
Yeah, I think they called it.
That's good. This will be a good opportunity for Acadia.
I think we'll probably see.
Hopefully she's all right. Yeah, this will be a really good opportunity
for
Acadia.
I think Silzer's going to take this. Mm-hmm. She tends to have a good cross from this area.
Yeah, she took one last game from pretty much the same spot, and it just missed the goal by about a foot. Hopefully she can finish it this time, or someone can. This could be really good for Acadia. Ball played in.
A little high. And
there's a scramble in front of the net.
Cleared out by X. It'll be an Acadia throw in. They'll try to get that right back in play there in the X end.
Hopefully they can keep it down here. There's not much time left, so.
I think St. of X will be making some subs to try and slow things down. Looks like
that's
what they're doing.
Yeah.
Yep.
Number 5 for St. of X coming in. Kirsten Desjardins-Lorime. And Acadia throw taken by Drake. And that will be another foul against St. of X. So Acadia free kick.
Blakeney will take this one.
Blakeney has a big kick. She will be able to get that right in there. Ball played in, but I think that may have went long, yeah.
Yep.
A little too much on that. It's too bad. That would have been a good opportunity, but...
St. of X will take their time with this kick,
as
you can tell.
Anna Thompson. Looks like we might have another substitution for St. of X. Zanetti winning the header. Zanevac's in the middle with the ball, playing it out wide. They'll take it up the field.
DeBrass.
Who's going to cross it in?
Connects, but just wide.
And there's 5 minutes left. Not much time. Probably be about 3 minutes of
stoppage time, yeah.
Yeah, extra time at the end. Which will be to Acadia's advantage.
But played out by Sarah Reed.
Kathleen Bleakney with the ball, playing out wide to Jenna Blackburn, who sends it up to Sarah Reed.
Looking for support here, I think.
Good defending by Sanevax. And just went a little wide. Easy for Anna to pick up. Ball played out wide to Brass, who's taking it down the line. Pressure from Drake. Andrew
Murphy
was able to intercept that. Drake again. Nice move to get by.
Oh, and Reed didn't step to that. It was picked up by AX.
Good interception. Olivia Zanetti with the ball up front. She's holding it up. She's able to get turned.
Murphy will follow that out. Picked up there by Dobek in the middle, but X wins it back. And keeper Alicia Doyle picks it up again with a drop kick.
Andrew Murphy with the ball in the middle, playing it to Sarah Reed. Playing it out wide to Jenna Blackburn. It looks like we're going to have substitution Becca Stuns coming back into the game, number 7. Not quite yet, but looks like she's going to get in for about 3 minutes, maybe.
Whatever's left of the game.
Yeah. Caroline Dobek with the ball. Not able to keep it. Sarah Reed picks it up.
Well turned.
She'll play it back to Jenna Blackburn. Out wide. Sarah. Keep possession.
Nice cross, but no one there for Acadia.
Try by Kiva to try to get it through the defenders, but not quite. X defense has been playing very well tonight.
They have solidly.
Up to Zanetti. Is able to get turned. Jenna Blackburn, good pressure.
X is just slowly working their way up the field here. And cleared by Bleakney.
Jenna Blackburn, the ball, not quite able to clear it out off the St. of X player. And that will be a unique goal kick taken by Kathleen Bleakney. Becca Stuns.
Becca Stuns is back in the game.
Wonder who she took off.
It's really starting to get dark out there. I think they'll have to turn on the lights soon for the men's game. Dragon, not taking the throw. That'll be Kirsten Desjardins, Lorimer.
Olivia Zanetti in the corner with the ball. She's probably just going to try to hold it up here and waste time.
And she actually breaks through.
Gets a cross off. And Alicia Doyle is able to get to that. Just playing it long.
For Silzer. some speed over there. But picked off by the ex-defender.
Looks like Becca may have taken Laura off.
Yeah, he seems to be playing around with
the forwards.
Striker position up front,
yeah.
That's right.
Well, I mean, there hasn't been any goals scored, so...
Mm-hmm. Becca sends it in the middle there.
Katie hasn't scored a goal yet this season, so...
That is right.
Not in regular season play, at least. Olivia Zanetti picks up the ball at half, sends it forward.
Nice through ball. Dangerous here.
Yep.
And a nice save by Alicia Doyle. Keeping them in what little is left of the game.
It's a nice ball played by Zanetti for somewhat of a break.
Yeah.
Breakaway.
I think they caught the Acadia Axewomen defenders a little high, just trying to pressure.
Yeah. Again, Andrea was pushed up, so there are only three defenders for Acadia back there.
And Andrea steps in.
And that's game.
That will be game. So it finishes with a 1-0 win, St. FX over your Acadia Axewomen.
Thank you for watching. And if you'd like to stay around, we'll be back in a few minutes announcing the players of the game for St. of X and Acadia. And the players of the game for St. of X number 2, Stephanie Cameron, and for your Acadia Axewomen, Caroline Dobeck.